Los Angeles Stars versus the Las Vegas Gators. Los Angeles star Raymond Daniels, considered the best sport karate fighter in the world, makes his WCL debut. For the Las Vegas Gators, will disciplined but dangerous kickboxer Thomas Longacre rock the strip with his thunder kick? And expect fireworks in the combat zone as boxing champions Jerry Seitz and LA's Alicia Ashley give new meaning to fight like a girl. Los Angeles, Las Vegas, next on the WCL.
Drop where the kicks don't miss, knockouts don't stop. If you slip, that's it, you'll be laying on a mat. Let's get ready for combat. Blood, sweat, tears, I hold back my fears. My team needs a win, I must persevere. I dig deep with strength and with my last breath. I fight for the right, for the title of the best in the world. Combat world, combat world, combat world, combat world.
Welcome everyone to the Orleans Arena here in Las Vegas, Nevada. Tonight, the World Combat League brings you action between the Los Angeles Stars and the Las Vegas Gators.
Ladies and gentlemen, introducing the Los Angeles Stars, Randy Goodtime Poe, Alicia Slick Ashley, Mike Palmiero, Hector Santiago, Steve Steinbest, Raymond Daniels, and the coach of the Los Angeles Stars, Colin Van Dusen. Let's hear it for the Los Angeles Stars. Introducing your home.
Amount of energy in the room tonight here at the Orleans, the hometown Las Vegas Gators into the ring, circling. Now comes the stare down, fighter on fighter. We will get the selection of the first fighters now. Los Angeles coach there, Colin Van Dusen, and he has selected Hector Santiago. So by weight class for Las Vegas then, that means Angel Huerta will take on Santiago in our first match of the night. To the rules we go, techniques that are allowed, all punching skills, all kicking skills above the knee. Knee strikes are allowed as well to the body and to the head. No holding, no stalling, no avoiding combat. Scoring will be by three judges tonight. They're judging on a five-point must system. The winning fighter gets 5 points. His opponent will get four or less. If there's a KO, that results in a 15-0 match. From the Los Angeles Stars, Hector the Professor Santiago, a five-time champion in karate. Santiago uses his speed and power from both sides to educate his opponents.
Smart, fast, and all online.
He'll go to the mat against the Chosen One from the Las Vegas Gators, Angel Huerta. Inspired by martial arts movies like The Karate Kid and The Last Dragon, Huerta goes for a Hollywood ending each fight through his heart and focus.
I do get underestimated a lot, and they don't see it coming.
Santiago versus Huerta right now.
Here's your first fight. Los Angeles.
Great match to get us underway here in Las Vegas. The hometown Gators, they're fighting in the gold. That's Angel Huerta. Hector Santiago for the LA Stars in the white. Evenly matched fight.
Both of these fighters very experienced in tournament point style fighting and semi-contact. We'll see how well they can translate to the full contact ring and the full contact fast-paced action of World Combat League.
You gotta follow that kick with something.
You just saw Angel Huerta with a nice spinning back kick. That's typically thought to be a point karate technique, but if you can land it, you can land it hard, then it works in the WCL.
Worth mentioning in the rules, too, that it has to be on the glove. If it hits on the forearm and the elbow, it can result in disqualification for the fighter.
the biggest difference between fights you may have seen before here in the World Combat League is passivity, or backing away, or not throwing a kick or a punch will provide a point for your opponent.
Absolutely, Doug. And again, you don't get a warning for that. If you back off, it's not like the referee says, come on, get busy. Your team can be penalized right off the bat. And obviously, the idea of this whole competition is to keep both fighters just attacking for the full 3 minutes.
Well, there's going to be six matches on the first half, six on the second. This is our first of the night. Both fighters evenly matched in weight, 147 for Huerta, 148 for Santiago.
Both fighters need to get a little busier again under this sort of point scoring system. They need to get busy. They're sort of used to the point fighting. I think it's going to be a learning curve for both these guys to realize what sort of homework needs to be done to be really effective in this particular type of competition.
Well, Huerta with more full contact experience than Santiago, and it's showing at this halfway point of the first match.
It's a slip there.
It's not a knockdown. Doc Hamilton calling it a slip. Huerta, the better kicker of the two. That's not going to cause any damage. Most of those punches on the shoulder. But Huerta's landed several good jump spin and back kicks and a nice right hand. He's ahead on points right now.
Of course, Las Vegas, the home team. We're in Las Vegas for this particular one. Dale Cook, very, very experienced kick fighter in his own right as the coach for Las Vegas. Wealth of experience there behind his team.
Fight!
Colin Van Dusen for Los Angeles. Told me he's been working the aqueducts with his fighters. Very steep grade on LA aqueducts, running backwards, sideways, everywhere, trying to get their endurance, their anaerobic endurance up for this type of match.
Now Huerta again with a good spinning back kick. Wasn't able to follow it up. Now a knee, but to no avail. Both fighters go down. Doc Hamilton cleaning off their gloves. Huerta has built up quite a few points with those spinning, those jump spinning back kicks in this match so far.
Yes, Santiago needs to get busy now for Los Angeles. Team, you're counting on this first one to really get the enthusiasm going.
Not much time for Santiago, and that's it. Huerta, the better kicker in this match. There's a spinning back kick, and he landed three good ones. That's an axe kick. Santiago wisely ducks, leaves Huerta no option except to just pound away on really no target areas.
Los Angeles is Hector Santiago, 9. Las Vegas is Angel Huerta, 15.
First match of the night, Las Vegas out to the early lead, 15-9.
The World Combat League is made up of world-class combat martial artists. The Total Gym is a critical part of their strength training program.
It's sport specific, so for the punches, you can be really, really creative and you work out your balance and flexibility.
Feel it in my abs, feel it in my chest. Great range of motion. This thing is so smooth. I like it because it builds muscle endurance, because quickness is what it's all about, not being slow and stiff. It's one of the best pieces of equipment that I can use.
Much better workout. I feel like my entire body is going to work out, not just my lower body.
I love that technique.
And that's a great knockout, Freddie.
Thank you.
Serious equipment for serious athletes.
Let the turf wars begin.
What is character? Is it in your blood, or can it be learned? Will you recognize it when you see it? Not if you have to ask. Hennessy BS Cognac, pure character.
Code Green, I think I've lost him.
Hey, haven't I seen you before?
You sure have. Look out!
Whoa! My car! It's too late to report my claim now.
Don't you have Esurance?
I do.
At Esurance, you can report your claim 24/7, online or on the phone. Always fast and friendly. You'll be back on the road in no time. Duty calls. If you're on the go, you've got to have Esurance.
Save on 24/7 claim service at Esurance.com.
Announcing the Subaru All-Wheel Deal sales event. From now until April 2nd, get great deals from Subaru, the only car maker with the highest possible crash test rating for every model. Plus, every Subaru comes equipped with road-gripping all-wheel drive. Right now, get $2,000 finance cash plus 1.9% APR financing on the Forester. The Forester received the top safety pick from IIHS. Get one with $2,000 finance cash plus 1.9% APR financing.
I get a little bit closer every
How's she running, Dale?
Tough as nails.
Any issues?
She's handling great. Suspension's dialed in. Loads of power. I think I'll take the red one.
The Polaris Tough to Beat sales event. Take home two of the world's toughest ATVs for an incredible $98 per month. And get up to $800 off the legendary Polaris sports bike. And now's the time to save on the hardest working, smoothest riding Polaris Ranger.
Now that's tough to beat.
Get to your Polaris dealer for unbeatable offers on the world's toughest ATVs. Stay on. Or get stopped. It's Man versus Beast Unleashed. The PBR from Omaha. This weekend at 8 on Versus.
We welcome you back to the bright lights and the fast action of Las Vegas, Nevada. Up next, our first women's fight of the night. From the Los Angeles Stars, Alicia Slick Ashley, a former dancer, this student of karate and kickboxing, has now been using her legs to punish instead of prance. Now she thinks of a fight like a chess match.
I am a mover, hence my nickname, Slick.
She'll go toe-to-toe with Las Vegas Gator Jerry Seitz. Seitz is a kickboxing and boxing champion who will try to hand anyone who stands in front of her a loss.
I always like to have an exciting fight no matter what. It's always action-packed.
Ashley versus Seitz, right now.
So Las Vegas out to the early lead. Now Jerry Seitz fighting for the Vegas Gators in the gold. LA Stars, Alicia Ashley. Both women, 5 feet, 5 inches, and scrappers.
Ashley at 127 pounds, Seitz at 126.
Seitz with the boxing experience. Going to be interesting to see what she does with her hands and if she can capitalize on that full contact experience.
Oh. Spinning back fist by Seitz, just missed.
Just went over the head, luckily.
Ashley looks like she's got the longer reach with her legs.
Yeah, she did a nice attempt at an axe kick there, didn't hit its mark. Alicia Ashley, of course, with a 12-0-1 record. As an amateur, 12-6-1 overall. Let's see if Ashley can bring that experience to bear here. Both fighters, again, need to get busy, though. Otherwise, they can risk that inactivity point against their team.
So far, Ashley is controlling the pace of this fight. Seitz coming back with some good counters. But Ashley is deciding where and when they're going to scrap. And her experience, and it looks like she's bigger. She looks like the bigger fighter, but in fact, it's only 1 pound difference.
Seitz got very nice defense. You can tell she got boxes hands away. She covers up there. And Ashley comes back at her again.
Whoa. Spinning back fist landed. Stunned her momentarily.
Almost caught it with the elbow there. That's the thing you've got to be aware of. You know, when you spin, the other fighter's moving into attack. You could get penalized if you catch other than on the glove.
Seitz misses with a hook kick, spinning back. Caught it on the elbow.
This is the second of six matches in the first half, and then each of these fighters will be matched up again in the second half, barring, obviously, a knockout or if one fighter can't go.
Seitz very slick inside. She moves her head, good head movement. She bends at the waist, doesn't just duck the head. But she's got to get more active on the offense.
Yeah, you're right. And that's the boxing experience coming out. A little bit of bobbing and weaving, good head defense and everything. And her kicks, though, she's coming through with some really nice kicks there. Ashley's timing is nice, though. She's avoiding a lot of those attacks from Seitz.
Inside is where Ashley could really shine. She's got the better hands. Seitz.
Oh, a couple of good points for Seitz.
Yes, Seitz, nice combination. That's what this is about. You kick and you follow up with the hands. You use your hands, you follow up with the kicks. It's the combinations that will impress the judges and score the points for your team.
Dangerous move by Seitz. She had just a right hand up, ducking down, almost ducked into the back kick. Gives Ashley a chance to recapture the momentum. Caught Ashley with the knee strike.
Very, very close. Dangerous weapons, those knees. A little harder for them in that they can't clinch to live them.
Second of six matches down, and Jerry Seitz doing some good, hard work for the Las Vegas Gators.
Hey, this is the best technique of the fight for Jerry Seitz.
Seitz spinning back fist there. It scored very well against Ashley there.
Here's Seitz. inside, knowing Ashley's the better puncher. She keeps busy with her legs.
Yeah, once again, Sides coming through with that spinning back fist.
Los Angeles' Alicia Slick Ashley with 9. Las Vegas' Jerry Sites, 15.
Jerry Sites, the hard work pays off.
From the Los Angeles Stars, Mike Pombiero, a multi-disciplined fighter. Pombiero has been studying for over 25 years, but has found success as a world karate champion.
I enjoy the art of war.
He'll face the Las Vegas Gators' Ryan the Lion Madigan. With power and speed to spare, this kickboxer loves to give a good swift kick to the head.
I don't think there's too many guys out there that hit or kick as hard as I do.
Pombiero versus Madigan, right now. In the third match with Ryan the Lion Madigan and Mike Pombiero for L.A., L.A. in the white there. Pombiero came out swinging. This, again, his debut in the full contact ring. A big surprise. Madigan, a veteran of the World Combat League, pretty much caught off guard. Pombiero on the attack. L.A. tightens the score with the win. 15-9 for Pombiero.
Woo! I got a little tired in the air. It's my fault. I started strong, but I got another round. So I came to the title this next round. So I gotta pick it up. Gotta pick it up. 3 more minutes. Let's do it again.
I don't know if they were looking at the blood too much or what. I think I outworked them at the end. That was clear. I outworked them at the end. Should have had it.
From the Los Angeles Stars, Randy Goodtimes Pogue. Trained in a variety of martial arts for over 25 years, Pogue lets the good times roll over his opponents, using his legs and movement around the mat. Pogue is a kickboxing world champion.
I'm definitely going to be coming at him hard and fast.
He'll face the Las Vegas Gators' Thomas Thunderkick Longacre. Longacre's awareness in the arena and speed makes the sound of his legs kicking an opponent's head in a frightening sound.
Lion's going to crack him. You can hit one of these.
Pogue versus Longacre, right now.
Underway with Randy Pogue against Thomas Thunderkick Longacre. Should be a good match. And this is the point where the Las Vegas Gators, as the hometown crowd cheers them on, could make a move.
No feeling out, as you know, in World Combat League. It's all the time. And Pogue is hurt.
Longacre trying to take advantage of that now.
Did he take a low shot or did he get him in the gut?
It was in the gut. It looks like he may have hit a rib. Something just took Pogue out of this fight in the first 15 seconds, and he has hurt bad.
Much to the delight of the hometown crowd, there's Longacre stalking around the ring. We've got a big problem with Randy Pogue. Medical staff is there.
This is the replay, and it looks like a knee strike, probably a broken rib.
Just what we were talking about earlier, just sucks the air out of you. Broken rib or not, you're going to lose air from that, and that had a devastating effect on Pogue.
You see immediately the reaction.
Yeah, you don't
see
come
that,
back from that.
And that would explain the kicking on the mat just a moment ago. Just probably the doctor pressing on there saying, does that hurt? And obviously the answer would be yes. Longacre does it for the Las Vegas Gators. 15-0 with the KO. 54-31 now. The home team is in the lead.
Okay, you guys ready?
Man is injured.
What's wrong?
Always ask for Pennzoil.
There's something about the freshness of Ireland that brings out the lasses. Now it comes in a body wash from Irish Spring. Smell like you're worth exploring. New, long-lasting Irish Spring body wash. All the freshness of Ireland. Bottled.
Welcome to Ranger Country, where the redesigned Polaris Ranger with electronic fuel injection outruns, outcarries, outhauls, outpulls, and outrides every utility vehicle out there. The Polaris Ranger with electronic fuel injection. Polaris Ranger. Hardest working, smoothest riding. For proof, go to PolarisIndustries.com.
Come on in.
Backed into a pole. She didn't even wake up.
Hey, Mike. I'll be right back.
Thanks.
These are for your rental.
That's it.
Body shop is picking up your car.
Right.
We'll call you.
Thanks.
Switch to Progressive and get complimentary concierge service. It's about you, and it's about time.
Combat League. We're back at the Orleans here in Las Vegas, Nevada, and next up, the big boys are climbing in the ring. From the Los Angeles Stars, Steven Steinbeis, the KO master, uses his power and speed to stop opponents flat. A veteran of K1 battles, Steinbeis will do what it takes to win.
I'm known for kicking people in the head.
He'll exchange blows with the Las Vegas Gator John, the Panther James. James fights for his family and uses his athleticism and smarts to win.
Don't blink, because you might miss something.
Steinbeis versus James, right now.
Second to last match in the first half, and the Gators could close the door, at least on the first half, with something big from John James fighting in the gold. Steve Steinbeis in the white.
No follow-up.
Caution from the ref.
Let's go.
And we're back at it.
John James, very experienced, 37-7-0 record, 26 wins by KO.
Steinbeis, also very experienced, mostly in kickboxing with low kicks. This will be one of the few times he's fought basically full contact type of rules. WCL rules allow kicks to the outside of the thigh also.
Yep, James with a nice combination, great example of just using of hands to follow up straight away with the kick. It's worked very well. It works so well for this sort of competition. Nice. Same again.
Nice combination, just missed with the roundhouse kick.
Let me tell you something, for his size, James, if he connects with that kick, he's got some power behind it.
Yeah, and again, it's combination. He throws them well. He knows how to get the hands to set the kick up. Especially when you leave the right, it winds that hip up and gives you a lot of centrifugal force and gives you a lot of power in that kick.
Doc Hamilton admonishing Steinbeis to keep his kicks up. John James, 235 pounds in a 5'11" frame. Steve Steinbeis, 6'2", 216.
Those warnings coming because World Combat League rules, kick's got to be above the knee, must be thrown in a combination of some sort.
Steinbeis got to get busy now. He's a little tentative. James, very experienced. He's just waiting for the right time. And once again, that right left.
James again working on the leg. Now brings his kicks up nicely to the head, too. That's a 6'2" Steinbeis in there. And it's just effortless for James bringing those kicks up.
Well, I tell you what, I can't help being reminded of Howard Jackson, the way that James is throwing that kick.
That punch ready when he kicks.
Quite a career.
There it is again.
Jackson is
having. Yeah, James catching him on the arms in that, but James just putting a lot of power into that right round kick to the head.
One more match to go after this. We are in the first half action here at the Orleans Hotel and Casino in Las Vegas, Nevada, World Combat League. Looking for America's toughest city, and the Las Vegas Gators fighting in gold tonight lead 56-31.
Steinbeis inexplicably passive.
Yeah.
He needs to be picking up points, and he's laying back instead. He's given away this match to John James just from inactivity.
Absolutely. Steinbeis moving in, but he's not throwing leather. And as we said, the whole style of this match has got to be when you move forward, you throw. When you move back, you throw.
Looks like he's waiting to throw a knockout punch, but John James is not going to be that easy.
James is very experienced, got very good defense. I think Steinbeis, the biggest thing, he's got to be careful he doesn't drop those hands, because James will come through with that right round kick, and if he gets that right on the button on the jaw, Steinbeis could be down.
10 seconds left.
The big men, a little less dramatic than we might have anticipated.
Yeah, finishing off with an axe kick attempt from James, but a little bit of inactivity from both fighters in this particular match.
One more to go in the first half.
Los Angeles' Steinbeis is 12. Las Vegas' John the Panther King, 14.
14 points for the hometown John James here in Las Vegas. They extend their lead, 12 points for Steve Steinbeis. LA Stars now behind, and the deficit grows with one fight to go.
From the Los Angeles Stars, Raymond Real Deal Daniels will look to use his height and quickness to his advantage. This world karate champion will use any part of his body to knock an opponent out.
Try and make it a little more creative when I knock somebody out.
He'll match up against Las Vegas Gator Ronnie the Kid Copeland. The big man has studied kung fu and karate, but is a three-time world kickboxing champion.
I'm fast, I have great kicks, I'm always ready to fight.
Daniels versus Copeland. Right now.
So the LA Stars got some work to do, and somebody got the message, because Ronnie Copeland in the white comes out swinging on Raymond Daniels.
Oh, nice spinning back kick by Daniels. Now, Daniels is quite a story. He is the number one tournament fighter in the world, but this is his first full contact experience. He has wanted to fight in the World Combat League. Was scheduled to fight once before, was injured.
Very quick off the mark, isn't it? Point-finding skills there, covering that ground.
He is a big, fast guy, 25 years old.
Oh, there it is, a spinning heel kick.
That is the kind of stuff that Raymond Daniels has won the world over. His techniques, his charisma, his presence in the ring, and now he's brought it to the World Combat League.
Raymond Daniels just got the LA Stars back in the game.
This guy has a future. That was right. I mean, he was busy right from the get-go. Beautiful shots, beautifully timed.
Raymond Daniels. Raymond, real deal Daniels. This is what he can do. Jump spinning hook kick. Flush on the side of the face. Copeland has nothing to be ashamed of. Anybody would go down from a shot like that.
Doesn't get any better. You notice what Copeland's big mistake was when he threw that leg kick. They automatically chamber the same side hand back, but that leaves the jaw completely open.
Los Angeles' Raymond Daniels scores 15. Las Vegas' Ronnie Copeland, 0.
That's a 15-0 knockout, and the LA Stars are back in it as they go to halftime.
I bet they thought they had us. Now we coming back. Here we come. Oh, that felt real good, baby. I felt real smooth. Gotta keep the hands working. Make sure I'm keeping my hands up. You know what I'm saying? Keep mixing it up. Keep mixing it up.
He jumped on me, and he's just got that initial point, explosion step, point fighting. Call me. Hey, it happens.
So officially halftime, and Las Vegas' lead is dwindling 70-60 at the break.
Required for U.S. citizens. Puerto Rico, explore beyond the shore.
When we redesigned the GMC Sierra, our engineers examined everything and overlooked nothing. That's why the all-new Sierra has the best expected resale value of any new full-size pickup. Then we added the best coverage in America for a new level of confidence on the road or off it. That's professional grade.
This lush expanse of green does more than beautify our world. Trees help clean the air of carbon dioxide, a major greenhouse gas. As North America's largest recycler, last year alone, Waste Management recycled enough paper to save over 41 million trees. From everyday collection to environmental protection, think green. Think Waste Management.
I've slain the dragon!
We come from our reward!
Well done! This is for you.
This is all I get?
Terms and conditions state that you must slay a minimum 4 dragons before cash is earned. Tail must also be provided to prove that it is a dragon, not just a large lizard.
Is this how your cash rewards card treats you? Introducing No Hassle Cash Rewards. Earn cash on every purchase, everywhere, plus a 25% annual bonus. Check your mailbox.
Oh, you've qualified to marry my daughter.
What's in your wallet?
This week, the Versus Saturday Sports Showdown kicks. It's the premiere of the Major Indoor Soccer League. See who gets their tail kicked when the PBR charges into Omaha. This week, starting at 5 on the Versus Saturday Sports Showdown.
Welcome back. First half down, second half to go, and Las Vegas, the hometown favorites with the lead. Doug Dunbar along with Mike Sawyer and Richard Norton. Guys, pretty exciting first half.
It was capped off by one of the best knockouts we've ever seen. Raymond Real Deal Daniels taking out Ronnie Copeland with that jump spin and hook kick. This is Angel Huerta and Hector Santiago. Huerta gets his team out to a big league early with his superior kicking skill.
This is Seitz and Ashley. Seitz coming through with a spinning back fist there. Beautiful job, very aggressive, showing their boxing skills.
Devastating knockout. Thomas Longacre taking out Randy Pogue with a knee strike to the lower rib. Pogue fortunately was all right, but a devastating knee strike, and Las Vegas, it just extends their lead.
Daniels and Copeland, once again, point fighters just really coming to their own in this particular match. Daniels, beautiful timing. You don't get it better than that.
Getting underway with the second half, and we have an alternate fighter. Remember, Randy Pogue was knocked out by Thomas Longacre, so in for L.A. now, and the white is Julio Garcia.
Let's cheer our fighters on. Second half action is coming at you now.
Don't hold him, don't hold him.
Garcia's got a big job in front of him going against somebody as strong as Longacre.
We'll see if Julio Garcia has a better fortune than did Randy Pogue in the first half. Took a knee strike to the ribs, probable broken rib. We don't know for sure yet, but it took him out of the fight in about 15 seconds.
You wonder if Garcia maybe got the instruction not to go inside to see that same fate, obviously.
Yeah, Garcia really learning his shots. He's got some very strong kicks there, strong front kicks. He's missing, of course. The timing's off with that leg kick.
Thomas Longacre showing a lot of confidence in there. He's got the benefit of having not had to fight very much on his first match and having won by knockout. So he's just full of confidence, and he's got the skills to back it up.
Yeah, Longacre obviously likes to settle back and allow the other person to come in on him, which he's Garcia's attempting to do, that's for sure.
Longacre with some good kicks. He tried the knee strike again, blocked by Garcia. Working on the legs a little bit. Longacre really in control of this match so far.
Longacre's got the skills. He's a great boxer. He's an excellent kicker. He's also renowned for his character, which is so important for the fighters in the WCL to show good character within the martial arts.
Left hand by Longacre takes Garcia down. Kind of a flash knockdown.
Once again, you look at the legs of Garcia. That tells everything. They get very rubbery. He's not going to recover from that one too quickly.
Steve Mazzagatti going to let him continue.
Longacre bringing those knees in. He likes to drive those knees into the ribs, suck the air out of the opponent. He's going to take advantage of having Garcia on the ropes there.
Longacre's got one knockout on the night.
Oh! What a left hand by Garcia.
Beautiful
Longacre up.
Oh, that's right.
I got to tell you, such a good shot, but Longacre still does not look like he's even stunned from that.
No, he recovered immediately. Just as experience and the toughness of Longacre to come back so quickly from that shot.
Longacre going right back to what he does best. using those legs.
Garcia needs to capitalize on that. Not able to, though, because Longacre is just so strong in coming back and piling on those points.
Very strong. They call him Thunder Kick, and for good reason. Some of the hardest kicks in his weight class. And another knee strike, just like with Randy Pogue. Down goes Garcia from the knee to the ribs.
Interesting. Longacre hit Garcia on the arms, but they're so powerful, those knees, that you're still going to get the full force through to the central part of the body. Longacre again, jumping knee.
Longacre, I think, got a little more than he bargained for with Garcia.
Garcia, very tough guy. He's taken some big shots, and he's thrown a couple of good ones of his own.
And a great effort by Julio Garcia coming in for Randy Pogue, who got KO'd by Longacre.
Nice effort by Garcia, no question, against such a tough opponent in Longacre.
Garcia had the decided disadvantage of his predecessor having been taken out in 15 seconds. What that does to your psyche, it can be devastating, but he went in confident, went in strong, and although he was absorbing these blows from Longacre, he came back with this one of his own.
Beautiful left hand there. It hit Longacre right in the chin, but Longacre just sucked it up, came straight back with his own barrage.
Big win for Thomas Longacre. Expands the lead for the Las Vegas Gators, fighting here at home in Vegas. 85-68, Vegas in the lead.
Remember how we used to tell people you don't need a glass to drink in a draft in a bottle?
Ah!
What the? Oh, I'm hit.
Ah! Yes.
Well, I've found a better way. It's called the TV commercial.
Drink Guinness Draft from the bottle, not a glass.
Ah! Oh, I'm hit.
The TV commercial.
Brilliant! Brilliant!
Please enjoy Guinness Draft responsibly.
Introducing the new AutoZone Rewards Card. Something special just for AutoZone customers. It's simple. The more you shop at AutoZone, the more rewards you earn. So get your card today. It's our way of saying we're proud to have you as a customer. Get in the zone. AutoZone.
We're here at Bruce Rossmeyer's Destination Daytona, home to one of the largest motorcycle dealerships in the world. Let's go talk with some new owners.
So I see you just bought this great bike. Man, is it sweet.
I can't wait to ride it.
So have you thought about insurance?
Of course. My new friend hooked me up. He's great.
You know, he saves people money on motorcycle insurance, and he's always around to help.
Geico Motorcycle. Let's ride.
Welcome to the World Combat League. Two teams, 12 fights, full throttle action. The World Combat League on Versus.
Do you want to own a brand new name brand computer and improve your credit at the same time? If so, Circuit Country says you're approved.
With my credit, I never thought I could get a brand new computer. But when I called Circuit Country, I got instant approval, and it was easy.
With this incredible offer from Circuit Country, if you have a checking account and can afford low flexible payments, you are already approved, guaranteed, for a brand new name brand computer. There's no credit check, so you won't be turned down.
The flexible payment plans made it easy on my budget. And my kids are getting ahead in school.
All you need is a checking account and can afford low flexible payments.
My new computer from Circuit Country, I started my own business, and now I'm my own boss.
And when you call, be sure to ask your operator about our exciting credit improvement program. Call now and we'll add a free color printer, a free 20-inch LCD TV, and a free MP3 music player with your paid order. You heard right. Free printer, free LCD TV, and a free MP3 player. Call now and tell us where you want us to send your brand new computer and free gifts.
I'm glad I called.
Stay on or get stopped. It's Man versus Beast Unleashed. The PBR from Omaha. This weekend at 8 on Versus.
Back to the Orleans Hotel and the World Combat League. During halftime, we found out that both Angel Huerta and Hector Santiago had gotten injured when they met all the way back in the first match of the night. LA coach Colin Van Dusen gave us an update on the situation.
A little bit of, you know, straight on impact. End up putting a little tweak on the wrist. It's more than likely the problem here. We're gonna take his tape off, check the hand and make sure that it's not in fact broken. If we got it,
be ready for the second round.
You know what? We're gonna go ahead and send in a replacement for at this point, just due to the fact that, you know what, your hands are your life, and it's not worth it on a fight. If they got replacements that come in and step over them, we got some good replacements. So we're going to err on the side of caution. Keep this hand ready for the next time he gets out on that ring.
So for that very reason, for Huerta and Santiago, we now see Manny Reyes Jr., a veteran full-contact fighter for Vegas, and he will take on mostly boxer Gilbert Sims in the white pants for Los Angeles.
Santiago and Manny Reyes Jr. Reyes Jr. fighting for the Gators and the gold.
Hector Santiago fighting for Los Angeles in the white. Certainly looks in condition. Let's see if he can come through and have the gas to keep going for a full 3 minutes.
Stop. There you go. Go.
Both fighters doing a lot of work here, at least trying to stay very, very busy, looking very focused. Triple kicks there, very typical of a point fighter there from the Las Vegas team. Both fighters being very wary.
Let's go, fight. Come on, man.
Oh, there you go. Manny Reyes Jr. with a beautiful shot right in the chin. Santiago goes down, but he's right back up again, ready to get on with the action. But that was a nice shot.
You all right?
Nice step up sidekick there from Las Vegas.
The hold. Fight out.
Two alternates going hard at it. Again, out, Gilbert Sims for the LA Stars in the white. That's Manny Reyes Jr. for the Gators in the gold.
Sims coming back very well from that shot he took on the chin, and he sucked that up and came right back at it.
Well, Manny Reyes is a all-around. He's sort of a jack of all trades and a master of most of them. He fights MMA, he fights tournaments, he fights full contact, he kickboxes. He brings the kind of well-rounded skills to the World Combat League that can make him do what you're seeing him doing in the ring right now.
Absolutely. Used to the impact, used to the stress of being in the middle of that arena. Sims are very aggressive. Oh, he nearly copped, though. Manny Reyes threw a beautiful axe kick that nearly caught Sims right on the chin, but he didn't score well enough to do any damage.
Sims looking a little winded already. We're only halfway through this match. Manny Reyes looking very fresh.
Sims still walking up there, still keeping aggressive, but as you say, he's got to start throwing later. He's got to keep busy.
Sims motioning Manny Reyes in. Come on and get me.
Oh!
And Reyes is down and out. Tony Weeks says no more for Manny Reyes.
It's a 17-point spread.
Reyes yelling he wants to get up, he wants to get into it, but the referee deciding, no, you've had enough.
This is huge. The knockout's going to bring Los Angeles within 2 points. Four matches to go.
Manny Reyes just really, he's not happy with the match being stopped. But again, the referee's job is to absolutely look after the fighters. The protection of the fighters is paramount.
Tony Weeks made the right decision on that one. Manny Reyes was hit with a stunning knockdown. Had he been able to get to his feet by 10, he could not have continued safely. That was Tony Weeks' decision.
Here we see Sims stalking in. Oh, there's a beautiful Manny Reyes. He's catching him beautifully on the chin. Sims straight up again, though.
Well, it looked like Sims learned his lesson on that one. It was more of a flash knockdown, but this was a stunning knockdown.
Right
hand. You see Reyes' head go back. You see his legs buckle.
And once again, as we know, there's a bit of a void when you get knocked out. You think you're okay, but you forget what's happened in that last 5 seconds, being flat on your back on the ring.
The referee declared that a knockout.
Fans here inside the Orleans Arena certainly not happy with that. Sims wins with the KO. So that's 15 points. That is going to put now LA in almost a dead tie with the Las Vegas Gators. And we've got four matches to go.
The second meeting for Mike Palmeiro and Ryan the Lion Madigan in match number 9 proved to be a much different story than the first time these guys met tonight. Both fighters coming out strong in the very beginning, but then kind of the depth of Madigan takes over. He's a veteran kickboxer. He's used to the grueling demands of the sport, and he ends up outlasting the first-timer Palmeiro, and happily so for him. Madigan, 15 points over Palmeiro, 6. That is a strong lead for Vegas, 100-89.
Special agent, they're trying to stop you from saving time and money on auto insurance. Here's the play.
Quote by print. Got it, coach.
When there's only seconds on the clock, Esurance gives you a fast break.
From all the hassle of buying auto insurance, you don't have to jump through hoops.
At Esurance, instant comparison quotes let you screen prices yourself,
so you can net yourself some savings.
It's a slam dunk. Save time and money on auto insurance. Visit Esurance.com today.
Announcing the Subaru All-Wheel Deal Sales Event. From now until April 2nd, get great deals from Subaru, the only car maker with the highest possible crash test rating for every model. Plus, every Subaru comes equipped with road-gripping all-wheel drive. Right now, get $2,000 finance cash plus 1.9% APR financing on the Forester. The Forester received the top safety pick from IIHS. Get one with $2,000 finance cash plus 1.9% APR financing.
I get a little bit closer.
Yeah, this is Utah. Welcome to our playground. Here you'll find 5 national parks, over 40 state parks, and more shoreline than the U.S. Pacific Coast. From the desert to the lakes to the canyons to the mountains, whatever it is you like to do, you'll find the place to do it best right here in Utah. So come see for yourself. Experience a vacation like none other. Request a travel guide at www.utah.travel.
Welcome back. Quick look back at the 10th match of the night. Again, Steve Steinbeis for L.A., John James for Vegas. They go at it. Both fighters, big-time heavy blows. Steinbeis, though, for the most part, fighting his own fight. A lot of Muay Thai skills. Spent some time breaking down James with the punishing kicks to the support leg. Steinbeis ends up racking up 16 points, only 9 for Las Vegas. So Steinbeis now brings L.A. within 4 points of Las Vegas.
I think it was a good fight. In the end, it came out my advantage, but he's a tough guy, and I hope to see him again.
On now to the 11th match of the night. Second meeting for Alicia Ashley and Jerry Seitz.
With only 2 fights to go, only 4 points separates Las Vegas and Los Angeles. Vegas in the lead now. Seitz in the gold for Las Vegas. Alicia Ashley in the white for the Stars.
Jerry Seitz setting up again. She's very good with those hands. You know, just trying to good timing, covers up very well, bobs and weaves exceptionally well. But you can bet both teams have got their hearts pounding now with the scores so close. A lot rides on this match.
Nice spin and hook kick by Seitz. She's taken a much more aggressive role here in the second half in their match. Both. Not waiting for Ashley. She seems to be wanting to go and keep that lead that they've got.
Ashley just not loading as much. I mean, she really needs to throw those kicks. If you're going to put it up there that much, let it go all the way. Just explode it out and get respect from your opponent.
Let these women know you're behind them.
Both ladies evenly matched, not only in the world of kickboxing, but also boxing as well. Both have a background there.
Yeah, Jerry Seitz, you can see she's just trying to stalk her like a boxer. Hands are up, ready, trying to get that knockout shot right on the chin. But Ashley just keeping busy, which again keeps your opponent right off balance.
Ashley with a good left counter. Much more passive than she was in the first half. Ashley took it to Seitz. That was a good strategy. This one she's laying back way too much.
Yeah, Ashley's just not loading her kicks as much. You know, she seems to be putting him out a little more like a point fighter rather than just going for the knockout.
The roundhouse kick by Seitz. I'd say she's ahead at this point in the match, ahead on points.
Oh, fake spinning back fist then, followed by the left hand, but didn't score with either. Seitz likes those spinning fists. They're a nice one. If you can land them on the chin, there's a lot of centrifugal force to that type of attack. Very hard to see, too, as we know. It's very confusing when somebody spins on you like that.
Well, with just one fight to go, guys, what's the strategy from both sides here?
Oh, there you go, Seitz again with that spinning fist, nearly caught Ashley right in the chin, but Ashley just sucked it up and came straight back.
Well, I would say the strategy for Las Vegas is they need more points. This last match, again, if Raymond Daniels does what he did in the first half, L.A. could pick up a lot of points quick. So Las Vegas has got to extend their lead and not get careless.
Absolutely. Ashley scored well on Seitz then.
All L.A. and Ashley have to do is just keep it tight, keep it close.
And keep it busy. You know, impressed that because, again, the scores are about the busy fight. If you're not going to get the knockout or whatever, then the busy fighter is going to get the points for their team, and that's paramount.
Both fighters fighting a very cautious fight, although Ashley just took a knee to the chin, got a little careless, took her hands away from her face.
Oh, and Ashley returned the favor to Seitz. And you see that? Really top Seitz on the chin.
Oh, good left hand by Ashley. The sight spun.
Less than 10 seconds to go. One more fight after this.
Ashley's got to be careful with those hands down low. She nearly got caught by sight. Stem and the spinning kick and the hand combination.
Oh, boy. This is going to be tight.
A great fight. The ladies doing fantastic out there.
Best technique in the match for Seitz. Spinning back fist lands right on the chin. You see momentarily Ashley, big blink, trying to get her wits back about her.
Yeah, Seitz likes that. And again, when you're attacking and somebody spins on you like that, you're very prone.
This is later in the match.
Seitz again, a nice attempt at a knee there. Nearly caught Ashley on the chin. Ashley then again lacking a bit of punch there. Not really loading her shots.
L.A.
Hanging on to the lead thanks to Jerry Seitz. But it's still slim enough that they could lose it possibly with one fight to go.
Thank you, no bull riding? Join Tractor Supply and Versus to test your skill. It's one for the money. Just log on to versus.com/TSC and pick the rider you think will win the next PBR One for the Money event. One lucky fan will have a shot at the jackpot each week. And every entry gives you a chance to win a trip to the PBR World Final, as well as other great Tractor Supply prizes. The PBR, Saturday and Sunday night. The competition is on Versus.
Cheering. Enemy of engines. Sharing? Pennzoil Platinum Full Synthetic with adaptive molecules that continually separate and reform to help conquer the forces that can tear oil molecules apart. Not just oil, Pennzoil.
There's something about the freshness of Ireland that brings out the lasses. Now it comes in a body wash from Irish Spring. Smell like you're worth exploring. New, long-lasting Irish Spring body wash. All the freshness of Ireland, bottled.
Welcome to Ranger Country, where the redesigned Polaris Ranger with electronic fuel injection outruns, outcarries, outhauls, outpulls, and outrides every utility vehicle out there. The Polaris Ranger with electronic fuel injection. Polaris Ranger. Hardest working, smoothest riding. For proof, go to PolarisIndustries.com.
Homeowners, want to refinance and get cash? Countrywide has a great reason to do it now. A no-cost refi. It has no points, no application fee, no credit reporting fee, and no third-party fees, no title, escrow, or appraisal fees. Absolutely no closing costs, so you'll wind up with a lot more cash. Call now and ask for a no-cost refi. We're America's number one home loan lender, and no one can do what Countrywide can. Call 1-800-641-0784.
Welcome to the World Combat League. Two teams, 12 fights, full throttle action. The World Combat League on Versus.
2 weeks to go, and the number one game in the NHL is on Versus. Ducks, Red Wings, letting it fly from Hockey Town. Next Monday, 7 Eastern.
Number 12, that is Andreas Spang coming in as an alternate for Ronnie Copeland. Copeland was knocked out by Raymond Daniels all the way back in match number 6 within the first 40 seconds of the match. So, with the score where it is now, this is a very tight fight.
123 to 117. This is for the championship here.
Let's see if Daniels can pull off the same style that he used in the last match. What an impressive fighter is Daniels.
Well, they say styles make fights. Daniels, 4-time world tournament karate champion. Spang, most of his experience in boxing.
You got to admire the timing of Daniels. He just knows exactly what he wants to do in that ring there. There's no left, nothing left to chance. Bang, nothing he can do but bend over and cover up at that onslaught.
Well, Daniels has the advantage of being as big as anyone he's going to fight. He stands 6'2", weighs 191, and he's got the added advantage of knowing that no fighter he will fight is faster than he is.
Bang needs to just close that gap. He can't let Daniels get away from him. Use those beautiful kicks against him. He's got to get in there and just rely on his hands to do damage to Daniels.
Left hand by Daniels takes Bang down.
6 points, the difference in this fight and in this night. Las Vegas Gators.
The tournament fighter with fighting the boxer but landing the left hand.
The Vegas Gators, all their hopes pinned on Andreas Spang. Daniels trying to stay in to bring the Stars to victory.
Daniels is kicking the wood. You see the beautiful time and way he evaded that attack from Spang.
Spang with a nice roundhouse kick that Daniels avoided, just missed. A little showboating afterwards.
Again, Spang's got to neutralize Daniels' kicks. If he allows Daniels to offload those kicks, he's in a lot of trouble.
You know, important to know, Daniels in Los Angeles, they don't need a knockout, but they need a decisive victory. They have to have a spread of more than 6 points between these two.
Yep. A knee attempt from Spang. He did grab hold, which is not allowed in clinch there.
Spang looking uncomfortable. He knows he's not as fast as Daniels. Isn't sure what he can do that isn't going to be countered by Daniels.
Less than 1 minute left.
Daniels getting in first with the right hand.
Beautiful.
Daniels needs to get out of there, though. Doug, Richard, if he stays inside.
There's going to be a point against Spang for that, I imagine, because you're not allowed to grab hold when you throw those knees. You cannot clinch.
Las Vegas cannot afford to be giving away points.
Daniels needs to get busy with his kicks again. He can't allow Spang to sort of get in there and neutralize his beautiful kicks.
Daniels needs one more knockdown here before this bell sounds in order to seal the victory for Los Angeles.
Winding down the fight. This will determine the winner here in Las Vegas as the turf wars are underway at the Orleans Hotel and Casino.
Oh, nice right, left, right combination from Daniels. He's got beautiful hands as well as beautiful kicks.
Daniels with a big right hand at the bell.
Valiant effort by both men. Chuck Norris, founder of the World Combat League, he likes what he sees. So does this Las Vegas crowd, but too tight to call, guys.
Very close. Raymond Daniels certainly has won the match, but has he won it by enough? Raymond Daniels showing he's got the hands as well as the kicks.
Oh, straight left hand right on the chin then of Spang. Down Spang goes.
Daniels has that look afterwards like, you want some more of that?
Just a beautiful shot.
Ray Daniels from Los Angeles with 15. Las Vegas, Andre Spang, 7. That makes the final score. Las Vegas Gators, 133. LA Stars, 134.
A one-point victory for the Los Angeles Stars. An amazing comeback. The Las Vegas Gators stunned after what they saw tonight here in the second half.
Well, Raymond Daniels pulled it out for him. He did it in the first half. He did it in the second half. A phenomenal talent in the World Combat League. Raymond Real Deal Daniels proved that all the hype about him has been correct.
A stunning victory by some accounts, but not necessarily by the Los Angeles Stars.
What a great night. What great.
fights, the World Combat League putting its stamp on the world of combat sports. Fast action, quality fighters, and unmatched energy. The wave of the future in combat sports. For Mike Sawyer and Richard Norton, I'm Doug Dunbar. So long from Las Vegas. Combat.